Associate Professor, Department of Hubli, Dr. MTP Institute of Technology. So today I am going to discuss about principle of step-up chopper. So before start off this step-up chopper, first what do you mean by chopper means? It converts the fixed DC voltage into variable DC voltage. We can simply call it as a DC chopper. We have two different types of chopper, step-down chopper and a step-up chopper. So in the last class, we discussed about the step-down chopper. So today we are going to discuss about the principle of step-up chopper. What do you mean by step-up chopper is, our output voltage is greater than the input voltage. We can call it as a step-up chopper. In other words, output current is less than the input current, is also called as a step-up chopper. We move on to the circuit diagram of step-up chopper. So this is the circuit diagram of the step-up chopper. It consists of supply voltage, and then inductor, and then chopper, and again a diode, and a capacitor, and load. As for the operation of the step-up chopper concerned, we have two modes of operations. We move on to the behavior of the switch here. Based on the behavior of the switch, we can call it as like a mode 1 and mode 2 operations. We move on to the, during the switch on period of the chopper, the inductor current is rises from I1 level to I2 with the support of the supply voltage. At the same time, the diode does not conduct because the anode is very low potential compared to the cathode. So at the same time, the capacitor discharges from like higher level to lower level. So this is the mode 1 operations. Coming to the mode 2, when the chopper switch is open, then the inductor, whatever the energy stored in the inductor plus supply voltage, both are pumped back to the load through the diode. Now the capacitor is charging. Now the inductor current is falls from the like I2 to I1 level. At the same time, the capacitor is like a charging from lower limit to higher limit. So again, we move on to the again we are going to close the chopper switch. Then again, inductor stores the energy. That means the inductor current rises from the I1 level to I2 with the support of the supply voltage. The diode does not conduct. Again, the capacitor starts to discharge from the higher level to lower level. So again, the cycle is repeated. So this is the operation of the step-up chopper. Then we move on to, this is the waveform of voltage across the chopper switch, and again the current through the inductor, and then voltage across the capacitor as well as the output voltage and the load current waveform. Now we move on to the analysis part. So during the on time of the chopper, the voltage across the inductor is like V is equal to VL is equal to VS. During the half time of the chopper, the voltage across the inductor is equal to V0 minus supply voltage. So now we move on to the how to derive the output voltage expression in terms of the duty cycle. Let us assume that there is no losses in the circuit. So when the chopper is on, then the voltage across the inductor is equal to supply voltage. Now I want to find out what is the energy stored in the inductors. So during the on time of the chopper switch, then the energy stored in the inductor is equal to voltage across the inductor, and the average current of the inductor is represented here I, and then on time, that is the time period we are going to call it as on time here. Next, when the chopper switch is off, so whatever the energy is stored in the inductor, now it is released, so through the diode, and then again go to the load. So now the voltage across the inductor is equal to output voltage minus supply voltage. Once again, I have to calculate the what is the energy stored by the energy released by the inductor. So now V0 minus voltage across the inductor is during the half time of the chopper V0 minus VS, that means the average current I under the half time period. Next, now we are going to equate. I already told you, so there is no losses. We have to equate the during the on time and off time, what is the energy stored across the inductors. Then V into I, T on is equal to V0 minus supply voltage, then average current into T on. Then afterwards you get the V0, we have to rewrite the expression. V0 is equal to V into supply voltage T on plus T off divided by T off. So T on plus T off can be represented as total time period. T of can be written as like T minus total times other total on time period. So now we have to rewrite the expression dividing both numerator and denominator. That T T cancel. Finally, output voltage will be into input voltage 1 divided by 1 minus T on by T. T on by T we can represent as a duty cycle ratio of the T on by T. So now the duty cycle varies from the 0 to 1. So this is the way we are going to derive the output voltage expression for the step up chopper. So now we move on to the application of step up DC chopper. So it is suitable for collecting traction, because here we are discussing about the load is like a residue load. You can go for the DC motor load. It is suitable for residue load. It is suitable for a traction load. Again, as per the solar point of view, renewable energy concern. So then it will produce the low voltage. Then we can boost the high voltage level also. We can go for the step up chopper. Then again, it is go for the electrical vehicle also. We can go for the DC microgrid. So these are all the places we are going to use for the step up DC choppers. So we have to look for some of the performance parameters. So that is the time stress needs a certain minimum time to turn on and turn off. Then duty cycle is varied from the minimum to maximum. And then the ripple with the load current also depends upon inversely for our chopping frequency, that is the switching frequency. To reduce the ripple current, then we have to choose the switching frequency as much as high. So these are all the some of the performance parameters of the step up chopper. So thank you.